servants, are you in what I'm saying? The wife you gave to me, why to blame the wife? Why did you refuse? Because you knew that the day you will eat it, surely you will die. Not only you will die surely. God said it repeatedly. And the wife said, oh, Satan came. Satan did what? Came. People of God, you want the Holy Spirit. Is God Himself living in you? You have the love of God in you. I don't know why are we still accusing Satan. Murutiki Satan. The same Satan you accusing. If God is not there, they will finish you. As He finished Adam and Eve in the garden. Hello? Are you what I'm saying?
Amen.
God is speaking to His people. Churches are dying. Because those churches, they have abandoned the word of God. They have abandoned to build on the Holy Spirit. You have a friend. You have a helper. It's the Holy Spirit. Are you with me? The Holy Spirit will help you if you want to be helped. Many people, many Christians, they don't want to be helped. That's why they don't lean on the Holy Spirit. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus. Be mature enough to blame other people for your mistakes. Are you what I'm saying?
Amen.
Recognize them. Be sincere with yourself. Be sincere with God. Fix them and move forward. Are you? Repentance. Repentance is what God is telling to that church. You call it loud. You say how loud. I don't know how you call it. But you understand what I'm saying. Hello?
Amen.
In Revelation 3, you know what I'm talking about. From verse 15 up to 20, what God is telling that church to repent. Hello? To do what? To repent. Christians in our days, they are no longer repenting. They think God is their friend. When you don't repent, you will miss the leading of the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit is grieved over whatever is not the will of God. Glory to Jesus. We have to repent so that we may meet the mercy of God. Proverbs 28, verse 13. What the Bible says, whoever repents will find what? God's mercy. But whoever will conceal what is doing, what will happen? Hello?
Amen.
Am I talking to Christian?
Amen.
It will be difficult to support my preaching. Many will run away. But I will bring to the church of God all over the world the man of God. I don't care. Glory to Jesus. As far as the truth is concerned, I will tell you the truth so that the truth may set you free. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
What you know and what you are doing, don't wait for somebody to prophesy it to you. No, you know it. You don't need the prophet. You know it. Just repent. Oh, glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Repent. I'm talking to the church all over the world. Glory to Jesus. Christians are no longer repenting. Churches are full of unsaved people, so-called Christians, who are not. Because Christians, they are Christ alike. They live like Jesus. They behave like Jesus. They do things like Jesus. Because the nature of God, which is love, is in them. The spirit of God, the image of God, is in them. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Oh, true Christian, they are enjoying while I'm speaking all over the world. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
I will not flatter you. I will not come and flatter you, people. What I will gain before the judgment seat of Christ, I will be an hypocrite. Hello?
Amen.
I know by nature, human beings need to be the light to be flattered. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Christian, they need to be flattered. I will not do that. Hello?
Amen.
I will not do that. I will tell you the truth. If it does not fit to you, up to you to take it or not. Glory to Jesus. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Back home, there were brothers who were defrauding in companies. When is my turn to give the teaching? They will not come to the church. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Today, they are sending me message. Muruti, you were right. You were right, Muruti. Says, because if I started to please a Christian, I will never be a servant of God. I will line up with the truth of God's way. I will tell you straight in your face. I'm like that. You can be my friend. That friendship must line up with the word of God. Are you hearing what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
I don't care to lose a friend. I'm caring to lose God. If you are a friend and you start to live like a chicken, I will write you off. I will honor you. I will advise you. If you continue or you do jiga-jiga, self-righteousness, I will write you off. I'm like that. You can be my relative. I will tell you what you need to be taught. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Those brothers, they were stealing money from companies, buying stuff, worldly stuff, nice cars, houses, but that money was stolen. When I will send them to the pulpit, I will forget them. I will tell them the man of God. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
I have many servants in the church. When others are preaching, they will come. When Murut will come, say, I started again. But what do you want me to do? Hello? To twist the word of God. Just to please you. Oh, are you going to take me in heaven? Are you going to take me in the glory of God? Forget about it. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the truth. Jesus is the life. Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
You know, we have grown up with malaria. The medication of malaria is so painful, more than malaria is painful. But it's your one. Are you with me? Do not have a choice. You have to take it. When you take it, the appetite is gone. You will be sweating. The smell of food. That medication all over the body. And malaria started to resist in body. You must take 21 tablets. 500 milligrams. When I will just reach 9 tablets, my heart started to beat fast. Say, God, do the rest. If you have to drink for me, drink the remaining one. I want to do it. And if I can't take it, glory to Jesus.
Amen.
That was the only medication who can neutralize malaria. Glory to Jesus. The word of God is the truth. People, they don't need to be told the truth. But anyway, we will do it. Glory to Jesus. I saw policemen arresting a true man of God, the holy man of God, for something he didn't do, he has never done, accusing him that is a drug dealer. In the vision I saw, they came to arrest him. He was trapped. Hello? He was trapped by jealous people so that they may arrest him. You know what? Those who can plot against the men of God, against the children of God, God calls it a scandal. The scandal will always arise, will always happen. But why? By whom the scandal will happen? Are you what I'm saying? Last month, God showed me a lady who lied against the man of God. I spoke on Sunday. On Monday, my friend Pretoria was arrested. And they spent 1 week in custody at the police station. The lady said she was raping me every day. And in the vision, I told that woman, you will pay for it. Very good. You will pay for it. The mother of the lady stood on behalf of the pastor. He told the commander of the investigation, he said, no, she has done it even here in Gabon against his father. She accused his father for raping her. She's mentally disturbed, that's why we sent her. In Helen Joseph Hospital. And the doctor is there with the file. There was a lady, a colored lady. She didn't want to hear anything. That pastor must go to jail. That pastor must go to jail. God will never take an innocent person for someone who is guilty. No, it will never happen. God took the situation in his hand. Glory to Jesus. Other police, the commander of the station, started to plead for the pastor. Glory to Jesus. This man is innocent. He helped that lady to be accommodated in his own house. Glory to Jesus. And she did what she did. The time has come when the people will accuse you wrongly. False accusation has already started. As God showed it. Be careful with accusations. Hello? When they accuse someone, listen first to that person. You cannot condemn a citizen Romans without hearing from him. Be careful. Because those who are accusing people, they don't have good intention. They will come to you. They will tell you that one this did that. You become even cross unnecessarily. Listen to the person. Listen to the person. When someone is accused, the Bible is talking about the accusation of elders. When a elder in the church is accused, when a leader in the church is accused, it must be on the testimony of two or three witnesses. Glory to Jesus. You must listen to the person first. There is nothing the wife of Potiphar cannot do against Joseph. This is the time of the wife of Potiphar. start to accuse the brothers for something the young men fearing God didn't do.